some Lonzo Ball talk, because Lonzo Ball won the MVP of the Summer League, mm-hmm. and I forgot who won the Summer League championship, but...
Lakers.
Yeah. So that was a good move, and Lonzo Ball has been playing very well. He's been almost averaging a triple-double, mm-hmm. and he played very well. What do you guys think? Do you guys think Lonzo Ball, after seeing him in the Summer League, is he a superstar? Oh, not really a superstar yet, but is he going to be that top player, or is he going to be a bust in his first season of the NBA?
I'm sure he'll be something. I don't think he'll be a bust, but he's going to have to adapt when once he gets inside the real NBA games, because when you're going up against Kyrie Irving, Westbrook, like, it's going to be a different ball game for him. So Summer League, right, it's a nice tease to show that, you know, he's got skills. But we're going to have to wait. But certainly not a bust.
It's going to be a test for Lonzo Ball because that Western Conference got really heavier with the recent signings of Paul George and CP3 going to Houston. So there's more stacking in Western Conference. But what do you think, Mark?
He has something that I think that you don't see in NBA players that you can kind of build or work on through. He has something that, you know, you just kind of naturally have as a player. Right? When you play basketball, you just know the kind of players that just knows how to play basketball. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of him. Like, and he's not the kind of person that, the player that kind of makes things too hard. He makes things easier for not just for himself, but for everyone else. Like, if you watch him play, the first instinct that he does is, how can I get rid of the basketball as quick as possible? And how can I get it to the best person to score it in the most efficient way? So you've seen a lot of players that are playing in the Summer League for the Lakers. You've seen Kyle Kuzma, who was what, pick 27th pick.
Yeah.
And who would have, no one else could have made him look this good besides playing with Lonzo, because who would have thought he's this efficient of a player, he's good of a player. And it's only because he was playing with Lonzo, who was really, he knows how to set up players to get them in position that, and that's something you don't find a lot in players nowadays. A lot of point guards nowadays are shooting first. A lot of point guards nowadays are focused on, and I think it transcends into, if you watch a lot of, you know, a lot of these players are looking up to players like Iverson, Michael Jordan, and you know, and follow them through was Baron Davis and like Stephon Marbury. So these are scoring first type of players, and I think a lot of players looking up to these kind of players. So when they go into the NBA, your mentality is to be a scorer and to be, and but the thing is that a point guard position is supposed to be someone that, you know, that sets up everyone that runs the play, and, you know, sets up the pace, and that's kind of what he's bringing back. And it's kind of nice to see that, right? Yeah. It's nice to see that a true point guard is bringing back that kind of style of play.
Yeah, and Lonzo Ball is very special. He's in a special place as being a Laker. It's basically a new era of the Lakers. Yeah. But speaking of Lonzo Ball and this whole draft class, Dwayne Wade spoke about it, that this draft class, this 2017 draft class, is very special compared to the 2003 draft class with Dwayne Wade, LeBron James, Carmelo Anthony, and Chris Bosh. What do you guys think about those comments about this year's draft class? Do you guys think this 2017 draft class might be a special, you know, new era of NBA players?
I'm going to need to see a little bit more of it, but it's definitely a lot of talent there, you know, like Smith Jr., like, he's something special. I looked at his highlights, and he's
they
phenomenal.
New York should have picked him. I don't know. That's what New York is doing.
No, but he's a phenomenal player. So, I'm looking forward to see more of this type of draft class.
Yeah. I don't see it as more of as good as, because if you got almost, you know, a player that's being compared to Michael Jordan, you got one of the best draft class. Like, that's, you can't argue with that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But in terms of the depth, I think this batch of draft class that we have, I think has more depth than what if they turn out to be what their hype is and how they played in the Summer League. This has more depth than maybe the 2003. It might not be as good of a talent because Dwayne Wade, Carmelo, Bosh, and LeBron, you're gonna need those are kind of they're Hall of Famers if you really think about it. But these draft class, you know, they might be hype, but they're deeper. I think they're deeper as opposed to more talented. I think they're just
there's
going to
be some surprises later on for the later drafts.
Hey man, we'll have to see because the NBA season is coming very soon. There's more off-season talk later on.